Okay, hi everyone. I want to continue with the discrete mathematics for this topic, which is the first topic, which is the logic and proofs. Yeah, and now we will talk about how proposition or statements in terms of logic presentation, and then how to actually prove them. This is the basic of understanding how logic works. Yeah, especially when we are putting them into practice in programming algorithm, how we can actually make sense of things and then apply it to maybe not so complex to a complex system. All right. Let's look at propositional logic. A proposition is defined as a declarative statement that is either true or false, not both. So it's either true or false. It's like when we are studying Boolean algebra. So it's either zero or one, cannot be both. Yeah, so that is a proposition. And examples are discrete math is Andy's favorite class. Yeah, yeah. Either it is Andy's favorite or not. 3 + 2 = 5. 3 + 2 = 32. Both are propositions, but they have a truth value. We shall call it true or false. The Earth is flat. The Earth is spheroid. The Earth is whatever shape it is. It's a statement, it's a proposition. So it has true value in it. There is no gravity or there is gravity, it's a proposition. It's like a statement that requires somebody or someone to actually define whether it is true or false. Yeah. And another example, non-examples, I would say study hard, punctuation mark is like a command, it's like an instruction. So it's not really requiring a truth value in it. Will you meet me for a coffee? Is a question. 3 + 2, and there's no following statement after that. X + Y = Z. We cannot know whether it is true or not because we don't know the value of X and Y and Z. Right? So propositional logic is talking about a declarative statement that is either true or false. Yeah, that's proposition. So suppose P is a proposition, so it's a statement that has a truth value in it. So the negation of P is returned not P with that term here, yeah, with these things, yeah. That is telling us that it is, sometimes it is written wiggly like that. Yeah, sometimes it's like this. It doesn't matter. It's just telling it is a not a statement. Yeah. So if I say negation of P, it is saying that it is not the case that P. Let's say before we state that favorite subject of Andy. So we can say that it is not the case that discrete math is Andy's favorite class. So if my statement is P is Boris is old, then not or negation of P is means that Boris is not old. I prefer the later, yeah. Okay, the truth table for negation is just the opposite of truth value of that. If P is true, then negation of P is false. If P is false, then negation of P is truth, yeah, true. And conjunction. Conjunction is correspond to the word and. So it's telling us if I say P conjunction Q, it says that P and Q. So proposition P and Q is true when P and Q are both are true. So if either one of them is not true, then the whole proposition is considered false. So for example, Andy is brave and clever. Yeah, it's a true statement if Andy is brave and Andy is clever. If Anda is not brave, then this truth value is not true. Yeah. So truth table for conjunction is this. So P is Andy is brave. Q, Andy is clever. So if P is true and Q is true, then P and Q is true. But for dress, when either one of them or both of them are false, then the result of that is false. Yeah. Why my camera is off? Okay. Or in electrical engineering, for example, yeah. If I do this is a source. Hang on. This is a voltage, yeah. This is, let's say, a 5 volt like that. And this is a connection. One, connection two. And this is 0 volt, for example. And here is light bulb, yeah. And then if I want to actually, this is a switch P and Q. So with this truth table, I can say that when P is on or true and Q is on and true, then the light bulb is on, so there is current flowing through it. But if either each of this switch is off or false, or both of them are off and false, then there is no output or the light is not on. So that's kind of application of this in terms of electrical engineering or any other aspect. Probably we can find some. So that's conjunction. And then this junction is actually OR. So when I say P disjunction with Q, it's talking about P or Q. So the truth value is that is if any of them is either of them is on or is true, then the result is true. Yeah. When I said Andy is brave or nuts, yeah. Brave or nuts. Not sometimes looking like brave, but not sometimes you're not using your brain. But anyway, it doesn't mean that doesn't matter about the meaning. But when I say Andy is brave is P and Andy is nuts is Q. So if any of this is true, then the answer is true. So the truth table is like that. Yeah. So when any of the statement, proposition P or Q are true, then the answer are true, except when both of them are false. Again, if I want to make it like the light bulb before, so I can just say this is a 5 volt, yeah, and then this is the OR connection, yeah, OR connection, yeah. So this is the light bulb, yeah. This is 0 volt. So basically, P and Q here, P and Q. So what happened is when P is on or P is true, then light is on. If Q is true, light is on. If both are true, then light is on because there is current flowing through the connection and then turn the lights on. Yeah. But when both are false, then there's no light to be on. So this is the proposition and the truth table for this junction. Yeah. And there is another one that I would mention is either or, which is symbol is like a circle. There is a cross in it. Yeah. So it is talking about P, either the answer, the truth value will be true if either P or Q is on. Yeah. So it means that cannot be both. Yeah. Only one will be on. Yeah. The truth value is you will eat either pizza or a burger for lunch. So you cannot have both. It's just like when you are told by your parents, you can eat either pizza or a burger, but you cannot be having both. So when both are true and both are false, the answer is false. But only when one is true, sorry, only one is true, then it is true. Yeah. So try to think about this. And later in class, maybe we can talk further on how you can make an example in the electrical connection that I just mentioned before. Yeah, you can do it as a practice. Okay, implication is if then, yeah. if then. So if it is raining, then it is cloudy. So it is raining is P, and it is cloudy is Q. So if it is raining, then it is cloudy. So another example, if there are 200 students in the room, then I am the Easter Bunny. if there are 2,000 students in my campus, then I am Easter Bunny. Yeah, it's something like a condition. Or if I win the lottery, then I will give you $5. I will give you $5,000, things like that. So the table for truth implication, if the P is true and Q then is true, then it is true. Yeah. But if the P is true, but the Q is false, it is false. So the combination is like this. Yeah. So all are true except when the condition is true, but the result is false. Yeah. So this is again, if you want to practice the another example of this in terms of wiring diagram, then be my guest and try it, and we can discuss it later in class. Yeah. And by conditional, so this is both ways, like the if then, but this is if then and then one side, and if then from the other side. So if and only if. Yeah. So if and only if it is raining, then it is cloudy. So there is no other reason why it is cloudy. So if and only if there are 200 students in the room, then I am the Easter Bunny. Yeah. Before, if, then, if can be that, and if can be the other, the result, the same case. So the cause is the truth table by conditional, we call it like this. So only when both are true on both sides, then it is true. So only one condition is different with the one with conditional before, which is the third one. Yeah. False, true. It is false here. Before it is true. Yeah. And let's find an example of finding truth values on this using truth table. Find the truth values for the following logic expression. So P then Q or not in a bracket, not P or Q. Yeah. So let's look at it one by one. So there are two of these. I'm just going to do one and then you can try the others. Yeah. So this is actually, we can just put a table like that. Yeah. It's not so difficult. So if I'm just having P here, yeah, I have Q there. So one, because there are two input or two states, then we have only four combination, yeah, which is when it is true here, true, and then true, false, and then false, true, and then false, false, like that, yeah. So let's just make usually it's easier to make us easier to understand. Let's just make one by one. Yeah, not P here. Yeah, not P. What is not P? Yeah, not P. P here, true, true, false, false. So false, false, true, true, like that. And what else? We have P then Q. Yeah, P then Q, like that. And we know from that all are true except true to false, except the second one. So this is true, this is false. From, you can look at the notes again later. And then the next one is not P. Just do it. I'm doing it one by one so that easy to understand. Not P or Q. So the second column and the third column. Or. Remember or? Only if there is at least one true, then it is true. So in this case, all having true except for the second one. So this is true, this is false, this is true, this is true. Yeah? And finally, just to do that, just the opposite of this, not P, the negation of that, P or Q. Yeah, here, just the opposite of this. Yeah, so false, true, false, and false. And then finally, the result, yeah? The result in here, which is what? Which is this one, sorry, this one, and this one, which is all of them. So this is the result, yeah? This is the result. Is what? Or true, false, yes, true. False, true is true. True, false is true, and true. So all are true. This is the result, yeah, of that by using the truth table. Okay, try this one yourself. Yeah, try this one yourself, and we can continue. Yeah, and let's look at more operators. Yeah, to simplify, we can have more operators, this and that, but we can just use that to simplify, or we can use that to compare with each other. Then there is the notion of logical equivalence that we want to know. Logical equivalence is like a equal sign symbol, but there are three lines. Yeah, like this. Like this, yeah. So if we say that P and Q are proposition and P are identical or logical equivalence to Q, if all their truth tables values are the same, yeah. So if P is logically equivalent to Q, we say P is equivalent to Q. They are equivalent, yeah. So this is just to test one proposition to another, the same or not. Example of this. Like that one, this one, yeah, this is the combination of them, which is this, yeah, while this one, which is this. As you look at the truth value of them, they are the same, there and there, yeah. So we are calling them, we are calling these two propositions, two statements, propositional logic, that they are the same, equivalent. Okay, let's look at some logical equivalence example using truth table. Prove that the following logical expression are equivalent. The first one and the second one. Yeah. So let me do the first one again, and then later you can practice the second. Yeah. So are they equivalent? Again, there are two proposition here, P and Q. So we only need what? Only need four. I'm sorry, my table is not really written correctly, yeah. P and Q. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Yeah. So in this case, so again we use. Let me use another color. So true, 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 false, false, true, false, false, like that. Yeah. So let's look at another. Thing here, one by one, we just find not P, not P, and Q. Yeah, so not P. I'm just go directly. I'm not writing down not here, not P. So not P, just the opposite of P. Yeah, so P is true, true, false, false. So I'm changing it to false, false, true, true. So false, true is false because this is N. False, false is false. True, true is true. True, true is true. Yeah. Sorry. False, true, and is false. Yeah. True, false is false. So only one there. Yeah. And then I go with this one. So not P or not P and Q. So what I'm doing in I'm contending the first column here, P, and the third column, and then directly I am negating it. Yeah, negation of that. So the or of first and second, so true and false, it should be true, right? But because it is negated, then it is false. Yeah, true and false should be true, but false again. False and true should be true, but false again, yeah? False and false should be false, but it is true now, like that, yeah? And then let's look at the other one, this one. So not P and not Q, yeah? So what I'm doing here is looking at the column of not P and not Q. So not P, not Q, false and false, and, so false. Yeah, false and true, false, true and false, false, false and false, false. So we can true and true, so true. So if you're looking at these two, so they are equivalent, right? So they are equivalent by proof of this. Okay, So please look at the second one here. Please try it yourself. Let's look at some propositional logic spatial equivalence. Yeah. So contrapositive. So if P then Q is equivalent to not Q then not P. Is it? It is a question. Yeah, it's a question. Is it? So let's just make a statement of that. If P is, it is noon, Q is, I am hungry, then if it is noon, then I am hungry. And then I change the statement using contrapositive. If not Q, then not P. If I am not hungry, then it is noon. Is it correct? Yeah. If I am not hungry, then it is not noon. Because it is noon, I am hungry. So if I'm not hungry, then definitely it's not noon. Well, sounds to me it is correct, yeah. But let's compile it later. Second one is converse. Yeah, some of the converses, P then Q, is it equivalent to Q then P? So you just switch the logical the equivalence the proposition. So let's put the statement again. If it is noon, then I am hungry. Can I say it? If I am hungry, then it is noon. Well, I'm not really hungry only at noontime. If I'm hungry the other time at night, then is it saying that it's noon? So sound like it's not good, but let's check it later. Inverses, so inverse. P then Q, is it equal to, equivalent to not P then not Q? Putting in the statement, if it is noon, then I'm hungry. If it is not noon, then I am not hungry. Well, I can be hungry other than noon. So to check that, the first one, yes, it is correct. Second one, no. The third one, no. Think about it later. Yeah, this is your video. You can review it again. Converses. Let's look at the converses. Yeah, you can prove it using truth table. Like I said before, it is a no. Converse. P then Q. Is it equal to Q then P? If it is noon, then I'm hungry. Then if I'm hungry, then it is noon. And not really. Yeah. So let's look at it, the table. So if you do a quick truth table checking on this, then you can see that they are not exactly, sorry, I should use another color. They are not exactly the same. They are not the same. Yeah. They are not the same. So we can prove it that way. You try to prove not other proportional logic spatial, please. On your own time. So it is not, yeah, like that on top, not. Okay, more. Again, another topic for this logic, which is tautology, is a proposition that is always true, and contradiction is a proposition that is always false. We can check something which is definitely true and definitely false. For example, this, yeah? P and not P. So P is true, not P is false. If P is false, not P is true. So if I say P or not P, so definitely in that or statement, which is disjunction, then we know that there's always true value there, right? So if P or not P is definitely true, am I right? Yeah, definitely always true, always true. But N, the truth value, must always, the result will be true when both are true. If you see this one, P and not P, so there's always false in that. So we can say that definitely it is always false. So we can call this is as a what? As a tautology. We can call this as a contradiction. That's what it means. Just an example. Okay. Let's do an example again using truth table. Check whether the following logical expression are tautology or not. But I think I practiced enough. We don't want to spend so much time in the video. You can do it yourself. You can watch the video later. Which is this, just try it yourself. But let's look at some more of famous equivalence, identity, for example. So P and true is always P, right? And if P is true, the answer is true. If P is false, the answer is false. So the answer is always P. if it is using am. But what P or false, if P is false, then it is false. If P is true, then it is true. So it's identity. So when you are having conjunction with true, is the proportional. If the proportion is in disjunction with false, is that proportional. Yeah. So if you look at the table, it's like this. Yeah. P and true, when it is true, so true. When it is false, false. Please make the others truth table using this statement there, propositional there, okay? And domination. Domination means it dominates. So when P or true, whatever P is, the answer is true. P and false, whatever P is always false. So please remember that when you are playing with the logic. Idempotent. Idempotent means, yeah, P or P, because they are the same, is just P. P or P, P and P is P. Because when it is false, false or false is false. True or true is true. True and true is true. False and false is false. So it's idempotent, just the same, yeah? Next one is excluded middle, yeah? Excluded middle is when we are combining with the negation of that value with disjunction. For example, P or not P is always true. We had it before, right? We call it excluded middle. And then uniqueness. P and not P, because this always contains false, the one that we have example before. So it's false. This is the name of the proportional logic, uniqueness. And double negation, when you negate something doubly, then it comes back to this its proposition like that, okay? Commutativity, yeah, this is like commutative algebra, yeah? So P or Q, or P and Q, we can just switch that. Q or P, Q and P, they are the same, yeah? And then associativity, you associate in the bracket like this. P or Q or R, you can move the bracket, yeah? Or P and Q and R, you can move the bracket. You can associate it differently, it's okay, yeah? And distributivity is when you can multiply because they have different symbols, connection. P or Q and R. So you can distribute that P or Q and P or R. And at the bottom also, like that, P and Q or P and R, like that, yeah? Okay, next one, the Morgans. Yeah, the Morgans is when you have a disjunction or conjunction inside, in a bracket and outside there is a negation symbol, then when you want to put the negation inside, then you have to change the symbol from or to and, and from and to or. Like this, not in the bracket, P or Q becomes not P and not Q. The Morgans 2 is the opposite using now this junction, vice versa. So not P and Q becomes not P or not Q, yeah? So like this, okay? Like that. So this is just talking about how you put the shading later, okay? Distributivity, okay, this is how to distribute, just to give an example using tables. Yeah, we have that, P, Q, and R. As I said before, there are proposition, which is, there are three of them. So the number of combination, there are 2 to the power of 3, which is 8, yeah? So you have the combination here, true, 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 false, just all the combination until false, false, false. And then we'll just put the value of P and Q and R here, Q and R, and then the combination of them on the left-hand side, and then this one here, and this one there, and then the combination of here, yeah? And you can check here that all truth assignments for P and Q and R, and then look at the value of them. They are the same, yeah? So we can say that you could do the proof of the second distributed law at your own time, of course, just trying yourself, okay? So the Morgans also, like this, we can have the same thing and they are the same, yeah? You can prove it by truth table. But the Morgans 2 here, we can try to use it, not truth table, but the theorem, the proof, law that we have before, like idempotent, uniqueness, and so on. So let's look at this. Not in the bracket P and Q, is it equivalent to not P or not Q? So let's look at it, yeah? So from here, remember before that not in the bracket P or Q, I can just make a double negation, right? Because P is the same thing as negation, negation P, Q also negation, negation Q. So with that, what can I do? With double negation, let me take out one negation out. This is just one way of doing it, yeah? So just to brainstorm, just to tickle our brains. So I put the negation out, but because I put the negation out, I have to change the symbols, the relation, which is from conjunction to disjunction, from and to or, like that. This is the Morgan's law, number one. And then negation and negation becomes gone because it's double negation. Yeah. So becomes not P or not Q, which is now what? It's similar to that on top. Okay. And last thing, let's look at this. Show that P and show that P and in the bracket P then Q in the bracket again then Q is a tautology. What it means is, can you check that this is always true? Whatever the value of P and Q is always true. We can use using truth table, but let's use the theorem, yeah? The law, the rules, yeah? So that's the meaning, it might be true. So let's look at this, yeah? First, P and Q, in the bracket P, Pn in the bracket P next, then Q, and then Q again. So if you look at the first one here, I am substituting the then becoming, remember before the rules, which is P then Q is logically equivalent to not P or Q, right? So I'm displacing that inside, yeah, here, inside that. So become not P or Q. And after that, I'm using distributive law to sort of like multiply inside, yeah, P and not P or P and Q. And after that, because we know that P and not P, there's always false in there, so the answer will be false here, which is the law of uniqueness, yeah? And after that, false or something is always something, right? Because if or false or something, if something is true, it is true. If something is false, it is becoming false. So by the law of identity, yeah? And after that, after this, I'm doing again the substitution for then, yeah? Which is not here, not here or Q, and I have that, and after that I'm inputting the negation inside, so I'm changing this value from N to R, which is actually the Morgan's law. And then when I do that, and I am, because it is R and R, I can use associative law, right? I can move the bracket. So when I have not Q or Q, there's always true value in that. So it becomes true, yeah, like that. It is called the excluded middle. And then true or something, whatever it is, it must be true, yeah? So we are already proving it by domination that it is true. So I guess that's it. I'm putting here some example. This is to prove using truth table whether the logical expression are equivalent or not. And then secondly, using truth table also, without, all of this without truth table, yeah? Using truth table is easy, but even though it may take some time because it's very a lot meticulous, you need to put down the truth value for each table and all that, but this one, both of them please not use, don't use the truth table, but just use the rules, the law that is given before, and find whatever the result. The top is about equivalence, the bottom is about tautology or not. Yeah, and let's discuss it later, maybe in class. Okay, all the best. Thank you, and I'll see you again next session.